could not do the DPS he needed to.
There we go. Game number two. Curse EU going to be on the blue side at the very least this time so they can get the first ban, first pick here. And, you know, I would certainly hope we don't see that Zen again.
You know what? I love seeing a Zen pick, but
I do. Yeah, it's just
it did not do anything to stop CLG. And maybe, okay, they can do it. They can ban Malphite, but at the same time, that might leave something open that they're scared of.
Right, and you know, I'm expecting Malphite ban. Actually, no, we're not going to see it. We may see Curse actually take Malphite for themselves.
I'd say, yeah, with that Olaf ban, that's a great time to pick up Malphite.
Yeah, this
first.
This would be fantastic. But we'll see if they actually decide to go with it. They could also decide to stick with the. Well, Cho'Gath isn't really worth the first pick. Most of the stuff that they had in game one wasn't really for, with the exception of maybe Lulu.
There's not really an easy first pick based on who chose game one. You're right. And I think they want to just pick something. Maybe I'd say Lulu would be an okay pick. Maybe Malphite if they're scared of it top lane.
Yeah.
With that Olaf ban, Olaf is one of the best characters in the game to Malphite top lane. So I'd say that's what you normally see against a Malphite. If you want to shut him down, and it shuts him down incredibly well. So it would be a good first pick, but at the same time, if they don't pick him, it's going to CLG, and I could see them picking it up one more time, because guess what? Not that many top lanes available for Hotshot, and Malphite, it's the perfect pick right now. It is a good setup, and we saw how well he did last game.
Blitzcrank's open.
Blitzcrank is open, but are they going to be confident?
Blitzcrank or Malphite, whichever one they don't get. I mean, I'm sure CLG Prime's going to grab up. Timer's gone. Nunu. Okay.
That's an okay pick, too. That definitely works out very well.
But there you go. You're giving it
there
up.
There is.
Not only are you securing the Malphite, you're also grabbing the Cho'Gath away, which can be absolutely, absolutely brutal. And Chouster, he's actually had quite a bit of success with the Cho'Gath in his own right.
All right. I wasn't sure of that myself. Just double-checking it. Yeah, it looks pretty good for him. So this pick makes a lot of sense. They do take the Cho'Gath from Curse EU, definitely one of their favorite picks. We saw it last game. Did not do all that much, but it was kind of because everything kind of fell apart. So there was not much he could do necessarily.
Yep. So
and he got the Malphite. They don't have a bad lane for Malphite. Cho'Gath can actually be pretty good against Malphite too. Darius. This makes sense, but you do not see it very often because it can go terribly, terribly wrong.
Okay, explain this one for me here.
So, well, I'll wait till they lock in.
Okay,
I don't want to jinx it.
Yeah, we're never absolutely sure.
Oh, please.
That's
so scary. That's so scary. I don't want to see it happen again.
Oh, no.
But he's learned from last game.
Okay.
If they do go aggressive, I don't think Angus is going to go for that dive.
And this could also be a jungle Zen because we've seen Lulu actually play Zen a little bit before also.
There we go. No Darius being chosen.
Okay, no Darius being chosen, but I hope that's Zen in the jungle.
If it is still Zen's out top lane, you know what? He's going to change his playstyle. They have a different jungler most of all. They have to have a different jungler because Cho'Gath cannot be jungling.
Right.
If it's Nunu in the jungle, for example, you know, he can swing by. The Snowball will provide a lot of early CC to secure those ganks if they want to try and shut down Hotshot GG early.
Yeah.
If not, guess what? Someone else will be to back him up. They have a lot more consistent magic damage coming out from Orianna. That's the big deal.
Right.
Because Lux last game did fine, but they knew that would happen on CLG. They knew she'd keep farming. Orianna couldn't really kill her because of the shield and how far back she played. So even though Lux did well, she has long cooldowns.
Yeah.
You land a Light Binding, you land her E or her R, that's a great burst combo, but that's all it is. And in the end, they needed the sustained damage to take down Hotshot.
And you also saw that when Hotshot was actually with the team, the orb was on him. You knew that the ult threat was there, and wow! Anivia going into the mid, that is a twitch. That is a twitch.
This is a Twitch-based lineup. We've talked about it before. Every time it comes up, it's the same story. You pick Twitch, you're depending on Spray and Pray. Looking at this team with Chaucer, they've got a bit more viability. They have a bit more options just because of the control from that. But your main goal is to have someone like Doublelift farm up a lot of gold. Use Spray and Pray in a team fight. Just get maybe 4 or 5 auto attacks off. Once you get enough gold, it deals so much damage. It is insane, and you can win team fights just with that one skill.
And the CC, this chain CC potential coming in from CLG. Wall, stun, rupture, Malphite ultimate is too much to deal with.
And that's important because you can play it two ways. Go aggressively, have someone like Malphite that can dive in, or go defensively. And they're doing both.
Yeah.
They have Hotshot GG, going to be able to aggressively dive. If he gets a good CC onto the backline, that might set up a good Flash Frost or even Spray and Pray for CLG. If they do have Chaucer in the jungle, Cho'Gath isn't really good at defense. That's a Darius.
Yes.
I don't really... Okay. Well...
Think about it.
Nunu, Ash, bottom.
Yeah.
Zenzao, jungle. Darius, top lane, maybe?
Yeah. I'm thinking that's about it. And Sona to wrap up this CC poison fest coming in from CLG Prime, just waiting for the lock-in on that one. So we were talking a little bit about Darius before. We're looking over too at the our stat sheets from Angish, and we're not seeing a whole lot of Darius play either.
So this would be kind of a scary pick if they did go for that.
Yeah, and Darius, the only time I've ever seen really like jungle Darius is in solo queue. So I'm not thinking it would be here.
All right,
either.
So yeah, looking at stats,
it will be top lane.
I mean, maybe he might have been doing it in solo queue beforehand. He might have been practicing with scrims. We did not get to record. This could be their secret tech, but Darius pick coming out.
Yeah.
This is kind of scary. So Darius has that big problem if he falls behind the top lane, and he can really just kind of be worthless.
What does that sound a lot like?
Sounds a little bit like Xin Zhao. If he gets ganked, because he doesn't have a good escape, how do you get away as Darius? Well, you can try and slow, and then you have to get the blood stacks and run away. And that's all you do. And it gets someone like, Malphite and Cho'Gath, because it looks like Hotshot GG is going top lane with Chaucer as jungle Malphite.
Interesting.
So these are completely different matchups. Hotshot GG, if he did have Malphite, he'd have to worry about the bleed damage. Hotshot GG is going to sustain the crap against Angish.
Yeah. Oh, second swap. Not quite sure yet. Are they going to do it again?
We'll wait for it.
You have to wait for it. It's never solid until you see that spec.
Hotshot, big troll.
Hotshot.
Okay, great. Now I'm a Chrissy U fan. Great.
Best troll NA.
I mean, really, I really hope Chrissy U wins this just so we get game three. But yeah. I mean, I hope we get a good game. That's all I want.
Good games are always good.
But looking over at this Malphite versus Darius top lane. Okay, so there's a lot of risk for Malphite. If he falls behind, we can see him just get shut down. The bleed from Darius is going to keep his shield from coming back up very quickly. Going to be about a 13-second delay instead of 5-second delay because it's extra damage being sustained onto him. And Darius does have a lot of magic damage. He has a true damage. He can really deal with it well. So it's not a great lane for Malphite. But at the same time, if Malphite just gets really beefy, if he gets another 400 armor, the magic damage won't be enough. The true damage won't be enough. And he can just kind of kill him. Just keeps walking into him. And there's not much Darius can do in exchange. Of course, Darius doesn't have any built-in sustain. The Malphite passive kind of works as built-in sustain. It can be a bad situation for someone like Darius.
Yeah. It's if he can keep the shield consistently down, and that is, you know, one way to keep Malphite off you. But I just hope there's not a repeat of what happened last game. That's all. That's all I want.
I mean, here is a big problem I think that Angish had in that last game. Mm-hmm. Angish, if he did try to fight against Malphite, if he did go aggressive, Malphite could max out Ground Slam and win every single exchange too because of that attack speed debuff. Like everything was not in his favor that game. The Xin Zhao pick, I think they were trying to bait out something similar to last game, and they kind of did, but that Cho'Gath now being gone, this is going to be a very, very weird matchup.
And you're also seeing also Hotshot going with the Cloth Armor Ward Potions. So he knows of the damage potential that Darius has, so he knows. He's ready. And he's looking to just stay in top lane as long as he possibly can.
He's scared of the damage, but not the mobility. He knows that if he does play well, he can stay in control. Use his seismic charge to really get away from Angish if he needs to. That's why he still buys the ward. So it's kind of like, well, I know if I get into a slugfest, now I'm going to be okay. Because Jairus will be starting boots. And this could actually be a lane swap now.
It could be. Double FDHBS sticking in to try. There's the orb. He does get seen. And a pause immediately. After
all right,
the orb,
now they're
going to
talk about strategy, then they're going to go ahead, check the stream, cheat, and you know we'll see which team comes out. Nah.
Oh, they better
I'm kidding, don't worry.
Nick Allen, you better be like right behind them.
There
like
are people monitoring
like
them.
With a newspaper to just like smack them on the back of the head.
Like watching the players play, it's fun because there is a row of people behind them from IPL. There's a row of people behind them from Riot, double checking, and then just like a bunch of spectators in between, everybody making sure that they don't do anything wrong.
Yes. So at maximum, as much security as we can. These players.
Unless we just like start grabbing their arms every few minutes just to make sure they're just, like hands on keyboards.
Hands on keyboards. With driving class? What is
this? It's like you want your hands at 4 and 7.
Hands on home row and go.
But but it's actually kind of funny. We have a 30-second delay on the main stream too.
Yes.
Well, actually on the live stream too.
Yeah.
We stream all streams just to make sure that players cannot hear and see what's going on behind them.
Right.
So everybody being kind of sneaky if they want to, but we're not going to let them do anything with that. You can be sneaky. It's okay. But it won't matter. We got you covered. And it's just a joke against the players. It's kind of natural for a lot of players to just be like, I want to do something, but
right.
Like even if it's just like not on purpose, just like, let me just look over. Oh crap, I saw something I shouldn't have. And then it's hard not to act on it.
Yeah, and we saw a little bit of that too during the whole World Champs thing.
And it's the player. It's up to us, the people behind the tournament, to make sure that does not happen. Because it's not really the player's fault. It looks like Loco Doco DCing.
Okay.
Could be some issues going on. I'm just gonna go ahead and waiting this out.
Yeah, so actually, for the time being, though, I mean, let's just come back to us, and we'll just talk. Hey!
Yeah,
what's up? Like, everyone goes, like, every single time, it's like, you know, we, like, say hi to Frieger. It's always, like, I love that wave.
I gave him a piggyback ride today.
Really?
Yeah, it was fun.
How far?
Not too far. Well, the thing is just, like, I was going towards the restroom, and it's just like, studio, give me a piggyback ride. I'm like, yeah! And I actually did like arms behind my back. Then he hopped on. I'm like, where am I taking you to? He's like, where are you going? I'm like, the restroom's like, okay, let me get off. He's like, all right, good. I don't want to take you in there.
I still remember during IPL 4, Rachel Seltzer Please was doing an interview with Huck from StarCraft, and Stefano like comes on in, and Huck just like hops on his back, and he just. Bolts
gone, interview
running
over
in like five. Like he managed to clear off like the entire main hallway in like 5 seconds. And it was like that is impressive,
Stefano.
Like, and if you're actually here at the event, if you're watching our stream, you know how big of an area this is.
Yeah, like, the Chelsea is huge.
It is impressive.
And that's Stefano, pro Trek and pro StarCraft player.
Really?
No, I have no idea. I'm just guessing.
Now.
I'm assuming he is now.
Well, I mean, if there's ever a track and field event where you need to carry someone on your back.
Piggyback ride, yeah.
Well,
makes the hurdles really hard.
Well, then again, we should just have our own little track and field event with all the ADs, you know, because they're already carrying the teams on their back anyway.
Ooh.
So yeah.
I don't know, man. I don't know. Some of these.
No.
This Patoy guy's pretty good.
This Patoy guy's pretty good. I mean, he's a fantastic last minute sub, and he's been doing great. I'm surprised they actually didn't go with the Blitzcrank pick.
Oh,
because
resuming.
It was open. But yes. We are back. I love.
Yeah, transition. That was good. That was good.
The transition just froze right on the yes. Just, yeah, we got it.
But we're back in. Come on, no invade going on, which makes sense because both teams kind of saw what happened, which was there was a Twitch and Trybush. He can always stealth in and be kind of a scout. It's risky, but it's what most likely what Doublelift would do had they gone for engage. And it's just like, well, they can't really do anything now. Now Ash. I think she benefited from this 2v1 lane quite a bit. She has a great chase potential. If the lane ever gets pushed in their favor towards their turret, they can freeze it. And while there's not a lot that Hotshot could do to really defend against it, but I don't really know the Twitch versus Ashe matchup well. I think Twitch, if he gets close to her, if he gets near her, just completely decimates Ashe.
Well,
and that's just because Ashe won't have the damage early on.
But this is well, Ashe Nunu, I mean, it's once you get within the grasp, once you get that first slow, the slow is just chain on in. And this is actually something we've seen from Curse EU before, actually, even you know, with their previous support in AD lane. And a lot of people underestimate how much damage actually Ashe can do with that Blood Boil. Because basically, if you have a Nunu support, if you have max out Blood Boil, you get a Phantom Dancer on your AD carry, and you have a Zeke's Herald. That's almost sometimes enough to actually max out attack speed on some ADs. And Phantom Dancer Phantom Dancer is a great item.
Well,
synergizes very well with
Ashe
with
has
that
one
crit.
Of the highest base attack speeds in the game.
Yes,
she
it
is
does.
One of the fast. I don't think she is the fastest, but she's close to it.
She's up there.
And that's what makes Nunu so strong. And her actually, Hotshot GG can go ahead and be doing his own blue buff. Something we saw coming out of Curse, I believe, earlier. Something they've done in the past too. So not too surprised about that. If he needs to, he can always teleport back to lane, but he knows that, well, he's not missing a lot at level 1.
Right.
And of course, their jungler are going to be Chaucer. He can benefit from the blue buff, but he doesn't need that much help in the jungle. And red buff will still make his ganks very, very potent.
Actually, he's got the Rupture a second. He could go in here onto Extinct into mid, making his move. Will he force a flash out? Yes, he does. Rupture perfectly timed. Flash down in mid, successful gank. You know what? I feel bad for Anguish. I really feel bad because he can't do jack.
This is not a good situation. Well, actually, he's going to run up to DCS there, and this is the problem because, well, Loco Doco Double have been kind of scared to really go aggressive, but I don't think at the Poison Cast, they're going to do a lot of DPS right now.
Oh,
it's going to hurt.
No, I just count it down.
Ooh.
Already. Oh my god.
Down to 130 HP.
Ugh.
Luckily, Twitch not running Ignite.
Hotshot.
Oh, this dive's going to be brutal.
Hotshot being pinned from three members. Look at Patoy, perfectly poised on the side of the turret, tanking like a champ. That was a huge hit on the Maluno, but it's okay. You got the kill. First blood credit going to Creative.
And that's one of the biggest and I'd say scariest tower depths that comes out there.
Yeah.
Chaucer going to the mid lane, that meant he wasn't camping bottom. That let them get into position. That's what you normally see a jungler support the 1v2 lane just by hanging out in that bush, just to make sure the gank doesn't happen. And I mean, that was a great play from Patol. You mentioned that before. He got the tower aggro. He got to the out of range area. He was right by the max range of the turret.
Right on the side.
And just waited for his chance to get out there, just so he could not die, but still absorb as much damage as possible.
Just doing the hot shot, just standing still and taking turrets.
Unfortunately, Hotshot can't quite stand still and take turret shots all day long yet.
Right.
But, you know, that's a good start. It's a nice 700 gold lead in favor of CurseU. They did get the early lead last game. However, Hotshot just missed a lot of CS right there. Only level 3 versus a level 3 Kraytan and level 3 Patoy, but don't realize they've split their experience quite a bit.
Yeah.
This is not the best situation for Hotshot. Shots are still in the mid lane, but well, Extinct really isn't in the lane right now.
Yeah, and then Curse also recognizing, like, okay, we cannot keep this swap up forever. Darius, he needs to farm. He cannot be pushed out so far like this. He has to go down bot. He has to match up against Hotshot.
And 4 CS to 17 CS. That's going to be rough, and actually only a 300 gold difference between the two. So Hotshot GG, his flash is still up. His teleport was never going to be relevant in a fight anyway, so there's not much Anguish is going to have over him right now. That top lane is going to be a little bit more in favor of CLG right now, but they're actually going to go for another swap.
But, Hotshot was looking to teleport, but I think an apprehend actually...
He teleported.
Oh, no, that's right, he teleported early. Never mind.
Yeah, teleported to get back to lane after
never
taking
mind.
The blue buff.
Never mind. But, it is still down for a while, but look at Sono, look at Twitch.
Well, I like what Hotshot did there. He went as aggressively as he could onto Anguish, which did a lot of damage to him. Guess what? He's going to go back heal, go to top lane, and now it's a half HP Darius versus Sono Twitch. And if they catch him by surprise, they can pick up a kill.
Well, Godoko waiting there in the rush double lift. I believe he is still stealth.
Oh, that ward!
That ward!
Perfect timing.
Oh, man. Wonderful, wonderful engage. And this is what we're seeing now. We're seeing the AD shuffle. In between both these teams, as you have swap for swap for swap for swap.
Ooh.
Trying to get the average, trying to get Lokodoko a little bit closer, but not going to happen here. But we'll soon have the backup from Ashe and Nunu just in a second. And once Ashe hits 6, though, once she hits 6, this game completely changes, because then CurseU, they become the shot callers. They can start saying when fights start.
At the same time, it does have a long ult. We've seen teams with Ashe before. They miss the Ashe ult because of the flash, because it just doesn't hit. Lots of things can go wrong with the ultimate. So it's important that they don't rely too much on it, because if you do just have the ultimate and it misses, you're screwed. You're not going to be able to start a fight. You can't really defend against the fight. But they do have Darius with his pull. They do have Orianna with her own pull. And, of course, Maluno, if he gets the proper dash in with and then his ultimate, he can really knock people back, set up a good initiation.
Yeah, Maluno working towards his first GP10 also. Going to be going for the Philo Stone first instead of the Carded Gold. Wants that regen. Doesn't exactly want to be quite as tanky just yet.
There's another swap going on.
Oh, jeez.
And I don't think this is working out in favor of CLG. They're missing a lot of CS all over the place.
They are.
If you look at Darius, he's now only 9 CS behind a Hotshot. And, well, he's been pressured quite a bit, missed a lot of his own CS. Looking at double of CS, he's down to 42 versus the 55 coming out. And Kraytan, who's also swapping back to the top lane. They know what's going on. They know they're just going to keep swapping. And the
it's a race.
Is going to be, who wants what lane at this point? I'm not totally sure.
We've been talking so much about the swaps, but the one constant here is you have the mid. And right now, Extinct actually has a pretty decent lead in terms of the farm. So it's at least a 20 creep lead around the bounce. So what kind of influence do you think the mids will actually have on this carry lane swap disco?
The truth is, unless one mid goes to buy, very little. Just because they're both so good at pushing Orianna and Vivia, and they're both going to get their own blue buffs most likely, which I believe they already have. But just because of that, well, a blue buff's still a lot for CLG, but the big problem is going to be you can, just keep pushing and force the enemy mid laner to stay there, because they'll just miss too much CS.
Hotshot throwing down a ward in the middle of the lane. I think that's.
I think he meant to click a potion instead. He has 5 potions.
Yeah.
And now he has no wards. And that ward, not going to reveal all that much.
Well,
it might have something.
At least you can teleport to it.
Yeah, at least
you have
it
that.
It can do something.
And that's actually.
But it doesn't reveal that much.
And that's actually kind of an okay position, because if Angus decides to push the wave, he can actually teleport behind him.
Yeah.
He's level 6, he could ult him, but.
But he would need someone else to back him up. He can't 1v1 him at this point. It's unfortunate, because I think that was a misclick. And it's kind of a silly misclick.
Yeah,
that's why I always put my wards in the non smart cast spots.
Yeah, or you can just do, you know, the pro thing. You can never accidentally drop wards if you never buy them.
Ah,
but then again, that's also never the best route either.
Maybe this could be a setup for a future gank where they try and kill the ward with an oracle. But guess what? Teleport to it and start a fight. I think it's just a mistake.
We are analyzing.
Yeah, we're not gonna justify. I mean, that was probably a mistake. Unfortunate
well,
for Hotshot.
Well,
but that's a good ward. That's a very good ward.
Yeah, is you want to make sure that you have at least some vision on the far end of a wave if you're gonna be deciding to start roaming, or if you need to back. And Big Fat, while he does, actually grabs up the chalice and the sapphire crystal. Just have a little bit more mana pool just so you can stay in lane a little while longer.
It can also keep you a bit safer in the lane, just so you have to go for a lane gank.
Yeah.
Go for a big surprise out of nowhere. That provides a vision for most every entrance.
Oh, he actually. The ward was right there, Hotshot. You could have teleported
well,
to that.
Well, he didn't see us. He's not going there to be aggressive. He's going there to kill that farm. And that's,
the plan has been blown.
It's unfortunate for Hotshot.
And you know what? This is. We have not seen the lane swap back happen for a while, so I think both teams are kind of tired.
It's like we're okay with this.
Yeah.
I mean, the CS lead going right now, it's definitely to curse Hotshot about 7 ahead. Oh, see, might be in a bad position, though.
Extinct forced to flash once again just to escape all the CC coming from CLG here in the mid. But you also have Maluno here off on the side, camping out the Bot River Brush, looking on into mid lane. And Ping's going down. There is the arrow actually coming in from top lane. Will it land its mark? No, it will not, unfortunately.
It will not land on Hotshot, unfortunately, either. I mean, almost it's Anguish, but I don't think team killing is quite in this game yet.
Friendly fire is not part of League of Legends, not quite yet.
Well, there's been some good bugs in the past.
Oh, there are.
Unfortunately, though, CLG saw that arrow come out, so they knew what was going to happen. They knew they were going to chase. Anguish taking a lot of damage from Hotshot. I mean, that could be the land they want. Down to about half HP, no Ignite, of course, on Hotshot. But that burst combo is always going to be scary. Unstoppable Force into a Seismic Charge into a Ground Slap. That's a lot of DPS, and it comes fast.
That's a lot of DPS. Is also a lot of slow, a lot of CC.
It's control. Yeah. How does he fight back? Well, he can use spells, but his auto attacks will be very slow.
Yeah.
And he needs to auto attack to build up extra blood stacks.
It's very impressive to watch Creation work, watch him farm. He's still got a very convincing creep lead over up on Devil Oath here, up in the top lane. But there's the flash from Logodoko.
Where's the ultimate?
There. Oh, nice.
Patoy.
Nice. Patoy flashing right out of the way of the ultimate. Flash for the slow. Does not get the ultimate. Logodoko just using the entire kit and getting nothing.
And unfortunately for Logodoko, I think he wanted to get the flash ultimate off. Did not cast it right away for some reason.
Yeah.
Could have been trying to burn the flash and then attack the toy. It's still two flashes burn, which is okay as extinct. Oh, doing some DPS.
Big Fat with the ultimate, keeping him behind. Does manage to get the stun, but I think took a little bit more than he was expecting to take from that one. But Chester here, not too far behind. And Maluno actually on his own, pushing down bot lane, grabbing tier one right out of everyone's nose. And Angus here looking for invade, and look, you found the Malphite yet again.
He just wants to give you rock hugs, and unfortunately for Angus, they're a bit too tight, a bit too much of a bear hug. Angus now in a dangerous position.
Yeah.
Gonna be able to safely retreat, though. It would be a 3v3 if they did go for that fight.
Yeah.
And now double up top, has
There's
a cleanse.
Nice,
and
cleanse.
Can he just get stealth out of here?
Does manage
all right,
to make
it.
Just barely manages to make it, but wonderfully timed cleanse,
falling
up the
all
arrow.
All the way home.
Yeah. You jerk.
And well, the thing with Twitch is his stealth was revamped. Usually it used to be up to, I think, 5 or 6 seconds that his stealth could be delayed. Now it's, I believe, a 4-second cap. So he used a cleanse. Ultimate is down for Creighton, but that's a long cooldown. That's a good, I think, 2-minute cooldown at the beginning parts of the game. So there will be a period where cleanse is not up. But if he positions himself well, if he still has his flash available, he will not be in a bit dangerous position. Double should be able to survive any sort of aggression coming out from that ultimate still.
Yeah, you're right. It's nearly 2 minutes, so there's some time to kill before that actually comes back up. Down back here in the bot.
They're just gonna slug it out.
Yeah, just absolute brawl fest going down here in front of all the mains between Hotshot and Angus once again. And let's take a quick look here also at what Molino's doing. He has his oracles. Once again, relatively early, so he's looking to do some garbage duty, clear out any vision. And strangely enough, CLG, they don't have as many wards now as they did last game. And
they don't have the cash to spare.
They really don't. They really
don't. It's a 1400 gold advantage in favor of Curse. That is noticeable. That can mean something. Usually, though, that's just a kill or a turret. Logodoko taking a crit from Ash. That passive doing a nice bit of DPS, but Logodoko can sustain. And he does have a decent amount of mana regeneration from his runes, from that Philosopher's Stone. So it's not going to be too costly for him.
Yeah.
And that's kind of the problem. These lanes are all... This game has been about laning. So was last game. And they're both trying to kind of focus on lanes, win their lanes. That's why the score is 1-0. That's why it's 13.5 minutes in and not much has happened in terms of flashy kills. But there's lots of tactical plays. People swapping all over the place. People moving all over the place. aggressive ganks that may not be paying off.
Yeah, and Double FT is actually starting to catch up. The creep lead is starting to close. There's only about 10 creep disadvantage at this point, and Creighton's actually pushing pretty heavy on over into CLG's top tower. So it's giving a little bit of an opportunity to farm. He's taking a few free shots, and actually the damage is it's somewhat on par, but Twitch is still a very fragile champ. He's a very weak dude.
He's very susceptible to bursts, and Ash and Nunu can do a decent amount of bursts. Not the most in the game, I'd say. Maybe a Lulu lane can do quite a bit more, but if he gets an absolute zero, if Joy can get that DPS up, that's going to be big. And Hotcha now taking a decent amount of damage, gets pulled back in. He should be able to survive this, but going to take a lot of pain.
Angish now actually has the level lead over on Hotcha. There's the flash and the dunk. Not going to be enough for the kill, but enough to convince him to go all the way back to the fountain. Left with about 200 health back in the reserve. Jester also with his own oracles clearing out some of the coverage. And back to top lane. Creighton actually did use the enchanted arrow earlier. But no kills, no nothing really coming off of it.
Cleanse should be up, but the next time it's up, Hotcha GG just going to teleport back to the bot lane. And this is the story of this game. Did we see Hotcha even use teleport last game?
I can't even really recall.
Like, if it was, it wasn't the most noticeable thing, but normally you see a teleport being used to back up other lanes. Maybe fight top, fight mid lane, do something somewhere. So far, Hotcha has focused on using it to get back to lane. That's, I mean, the only use it's had.
Right.
And he picks up some more CS, he stays relevant, but it's not CLG North America making big plays. It's just a very, very passive farm fight. So the question is going to be, who outscales who?
Yeah.
Zenza about 20 CS behind Cho'Gath right now, but, you know, he doesn't necessarily need that much farm if he can stay alive. And he has a Wriggles, he's going to be kind of beefy. He has a Philosopher's Stone taken too. That's not a lot of HP, but it might be enough.
Yeah. He's also got the assist on him, too, which helps out.
So yeah, a little bit.
Just a little bit.
And just bit by bit. And that's kind of how this game is going. It's like, well, I think my team can outskill your team. Let's just keep farming. And that, well, Orianna's really strong late game. So is Ashe at the same time. And Twitch, also one of the best, like, team killers in the entire game. I mean, the enemy team killing all of them at once. And Hotcha, can he still land against Angish?
He could, but there is an extinct coming on down. Their pings went down like mad from Prime over to the South River. They already pinged it out. It's like they told him, hey, Orianna's coming for you. You may want to back off on this one. And indeed he does. You also got Cho'Gath coming up here into the top lane. The coverage is clear. Double with stealth. Is he going to be looking to make a play here? There he goes. Sona ult. Actually landing this time. The arrow went backwards?
Yeah, I think he misclicked. Oh, but I think they're going to get out of this. They just flash out. They're walking out. Actually, look at the damage going down to Double Up, down to about half HP.
Loco Doco. The slows maybe a bit too much. The volley right on the tail end, able to get the kill onto Sona. Wow.
So slight.
That's like that niddly bug almost, where it just goes the complete opposite
direction. Yeah, maybe that was a misclick. Maybe there was a weird bug going on. Doesn't really matter because he still didn't need the arrow,
he didn't need it.
And I mean, they forced the flash out of Doubles. They forced the flash out of Loco Doco. Just not enough damage.
Shouster,
could go for a toy snipe, looking for that burst maybe.
Is his feast up? Yes, it is. You get the CC down onto the Nunu. Could be enough. And Double actually still tells he's still in the area. There goes the Noms. Silence not getting enough. And Twitch goes down underneath his own tower. Creighton delayed off on the side. He's like, hey, there's a weak rat over here. I think they kill him instead. There's the rupture followed behind the wall. Big Bad LP now up here in the top lane with all of the damage down and the shutdown taking out the Ash. Nice travel here to the top from Big Bad LP.
And that's such an unfortunate circumstance for CLG. They give up two kills. They keep going for these fights. Now mid lane being pressured. They did pick up Creighton in the end, but really what was that? Once the Sona ultimate got flashed, Patoy being a bit too tanky, and Creighton not getting hit by was able to do enough DPS, chased on Loco, chased on Double Up, and that frosted arrow, that Q from Sona, or from Ash, too much to escape from.
And you're still getting this push on here in the bot. Turret taking down 5 and Nasix, you're taking a little bit too much turret aggro, but there is the apprehend, keeping the Malphite behind. There's the Orianna Orb. The ultimate is up and ready when necessary, whenever you want to secure your kill. Ultimate also back up on Darius, so if he can get some dunks, get some threes, and wants a Malphite. All two members of Curse popped up. Orianna and Darius are a little bit slow. There's Big Bad with the wall, keeping Darius behind. But Orianna ult keeping everyone from CLG in. The egg on Anivia. The damage is too great. Curse getting the kill on the Big Bad. Arrow
cleanse
top lane.
Up. Can he get out?
There's the cleanse. Double it, but is it soon enough? No, it is not. The new ult to keep you behind. Oh, Patoy with that
good kill right there. They're picking them kills all over the place. 5-1 right now.
Yep.
They go 1-1 top, or 2-1. But every time CLG goes for a play, every time they try to force one, Curse is there ready to respond. Sometimes it's just based off their flashes. Sometimes it was like that fight bot lane where, well, they used Hotshot GG's Unstoppable Force, but who deals more damage? Who really had more control of that fight? It was going to be the Orianna ultimate hitting all three of them. It was going to be Zen Zhao with his ultimate knocking Hotshot GG and Chaucer into a wall where they could not keep fighting, could not really deal that much to stop the Ludo from going aggressive, and it was the perfect set to punish CLG for going aggressive themselves.
Yeah.
I mean, now that Rebirth is down for another 4 months, they got nothing out of it, just losing...
Straight up.
LP, like, just like they just lost him. And, yeah. Well, that's going to be a four-minute period where Curse can now go extra aggressive. They can kind of do what they want. Dragon, at some point, got picked up, I want to say, by Curse, just because they have that gold lead. And it's looking kind of scary for CLG. 5-1, but a 6,000 gold lead in favor of Curse EU.
Now, we talked a little bit, Champ Select, about the Twitch. And Double Lift, there hasn't really been a full 5-on-5 team fight. And a lot of the damage inherent in CLG Prime is coming from the rat. Do you think what does CLG need to do in order to get the maximum effectiveness besides Hotshot getting caught out here in the top lane? Will we actually be able to get here? The Frost Arrows are a bit too
His
much.
Ultimate is up.
His ultimate is up. We'll be able to dash out of the way. But here comes Orianna with an Anivia in pursuit. Got the Orianna Orb, Ash Arrow coming in. The pop-up will die before he ever hits the ground.
No scope snipes coming out of Extinct right there.
Yeah, there's Double Lift farming the bot.
Double Lift can die to Angish. He doesn't have his flash. It's going to be for a few more seconds, and Angish, I don't think he can confidently go for the kill, but that is a possibility, and right now that's kind of the problem. Double Lift looking at his items. Oh, Angish going aggressive now.
One,
can he just take him out in stealth? Will it be enough?
I'm not sure if it will be. The start there.
He needs the ult.
No.
Oh.
Gets out just in time. The bleed trail.
Oh, the bleed almost killed him, taking him about 260 HP. And look at Angish's build. He's going for a tanky DPS style build. Has two GP10 items, has that Giant's Belt, but a Hex Drinker to kind of give him a bit more oomph in his kills.
Yeah.
But the problem with Double Lift right now, his CS, it's okay, a little bit behind Creighton, but he doesn't have items, he doesn't have kills, he has an assist, his team doesn't have turrets or dragons or really anything.
Yeah.
And that's what's scary, that's what makes it such a big problem. They don't have enough on that Twitch. It's going to be the crux of their team at this point. If he cannot really get a good Spray and Pray off, if they cannot have him do enough damage, it's just going to be... I mean, look at Angus. Look at how much damage he's taking.
That's quite a bit. And imagine a full 5-on-5 teamfight, how huge that would be. But Chester off from behind does manage to pinch Angus. Three members of CLG crushing Darius here, but can he get the dunk? There's the Sona ult a little bit too late.
Oh, he's taking the bleed out, kill Double Lift.
I'm not so sure, but the heals.
Loco Doco. Saves him.
Healing it on out. Big Fat, though, does get caught by Curse EU, does flash over the wall back into the base from their north jungle. And Curse, they know they're in an okay spot here, though. Even though they managed to lose Angish, they can still force plays. Hotshot getting caught out once again. Will he die? There is the ice wall, not going to be enough. Another kill on Hotshot.
And found a way to stop Unstoppable Force, kill him as it goes on. It looks like he actually just used the ult at a very short range, knocking up a Luno in the process, but... Well, I mean, Angus, he's got the damage, almost able to take out Twitch in that exchange, and that's the problem. They just have too much gold. Darius dealing too much damage. He did have to burn Ignite, did use his ultimate there, but I mean, it's not going to be a big issue if he uses ultimate Ignite in a big teamfight like that. Someone like Chaucer, how tanky is he? Doesn't have his Frozen Heart finish, just a Glacial Shroud, not being able to really take that much damage. And kind of across the board, Hotshot GG, we saw 400 armor with his W activated last time. This time going to be more, well, how much armor does he have? How tanky is Hotshot?
That's, he's...
150 armor versus 270.
Not nearly as much as last time.
And his HP is relatively low compared to what he used to be like. He just doesn't have enough at this point.
Right.
There's a lot more magic damage. There is a true damage coming out of Darius. There's a lot to kill Hotshot. There is not really a front line necessarily. So they need Double Lift to be in the back. They need to make the fight go towards Double Lift. And Double Lift to kite them back with Chaucer protecting him with Big Fat LP. That arrow, is it going to land?
Limbo's right under it, the Iceberg. Big Fat will not be caught with that stun today. Even then, I'm not so sure if it would have been a kill. It was only Extinct in the area. So, granted, it would have been a huge chunk. I'll probably bring him down to about 25%. But I think it's more try and create a position, try and displace members of CLG, where you can create an opportunity where you can take objectives like Dragon or maybe even Baron.
I mean, maybe they could force the Rebirth. They could have done something with it, and that would have given them a chance to get Dragon very safely instead of just pretty safely. At this point, Hotshot does have his teleport up. We might see him go for a teleport gank. Baron being looked at. No ward. Oh, there is a ward for CLG. So if they do go for it now, it will be spotted. Ping's going onto them. The rest of CLG is in the area. Besides Hotshot, who once again, he's got teleport. Ping's out of Chaucer. Another ward, as they just have not walked right next to it yet. So
yeah.
It doesn't provide that much vision either.
Yeah, it's not too much vision, but I mean, it's sometimes just enough to realize that if someone's actually approaches, makes the approach in from the blue ramp.
Yeah,
on Curse's
at a minimum, it's a great place to have Hotshot teleport to, because it catches him by off guard.
Oh, yeah. It's like, oh, I didn't think a Malphite would ever come in from an angle. Uses the Ensemble Force, does not get created. The flash from Ash is just a bit too quick, but the rest of CLG is there to collapse, and Ash caught out away from the rest of the team.
Oh,
and
they're running now.
There are so many pings going down. Prime knows they could be still in a little bit of trouble because there is a lot of damage on that Darius. But Double Up actually relatively safe.
Oh, that ultimate!
Now, the ultimate, but Double Up still over on the side of the fight. Extinct going to be going down. There's a slam down Double Up, but he had no stacks. Not as much tree damage as like Soda going down. The pooks coming from Aludo getting that kill. But that is a double for Twitch. Double for Double. That is a 4-for-2 in CLG Prime's favor.
Is this a Baron?
I think they might. The Hotshot's tanky enough. He may not be as tanky as he was last time.
But
he
can still take a
they
Baron.
Can still take a Baron.
Double Up has the damage. Now has Infinity completed. Well, that fight, they kept trying to dive kind of different people. Double Up was the focus of Angish and I'd say a little bit of Malo towards the end there. But oh, ultimate from Ash. This could be enough. That CC, that Baron damage.
This
one's
going
to be hot. How low is Baron now? Down to about 3,000 HP. They're going to be able to finish this. Consume from Patoy might be it.
Patoy, if he can get a flash Q on this, that would be amazing. But he's actually throwing down the ult, so he wants to delay as much as possible. But it will.
It's going to go down. Creighton, can you get the snipe?
Does kill Hotshot. Does get the snipe. Creighton with the kill. The steal on the Baron walks all the way up, and one volley is more than enough to steal the Baron. Holy crap, man.
Now, two dead on CLG, Baron buff on every member of Curse except for Patoy, and they're looking good, they're looking strong. They messed up that fight. They dove Double Up, they did not have their AD carry, they could not do that. But guess what? Drayton's back alive, 5-2-2, Infinity Edge, Phantom Dancer completed. They're going to push down mid, they're going to go aggressive, they're going to try and take as much down as they can.
CLG Prime bet it all on red, it came up black. And now CurseU has the Baron buff, and they will be pushing on in. The tier 3 in mid about to fall, along with the mid inhib. Nunu going to be coming back. Enough of a hero where he delayed, and Creation with the one arrow, the singular arrow, to help everything out.
They did that perfectly. Patoy threw himself at CLG. It's like, all right, I'm going to die, but I'm going to waste so much time. Creighton with that Phantom Dancer, barely able to get in range. That was just it. It was all so tight, so close to not being successful. But you know what?
Ooh,
that was actually very tight. No, that's not tight. That does land.
There's Patoy going to follow on up. This time, finally, the cross-map arrow. The Ash arrow finally hits its mark. Onto Anivia, frost on frost, and Curse can take this advantage. Hotshot's not with the team.
He does have teleport up. They could try and backdoor this bot turret. If they do so, ping from CLG onto that bot turret. I think they expect the backdoor there. If that does happen, Hotshot can TP, try and catch him by surprise if they want to. That might be their plan.
He's tanking out the tier 3 and bot straight out. Angus will be next on that list. And here comes Chester actually pulled on in. Malphite ult right on the back line of first, but Creighton is actually relatively safe here. Here comes the Sona ult. Loco Doco trying to kill as much time as possible with the Hotshot. Is cornered between all of Curse. Loco Doco off on the side. You got the rest of the damage. Double lift, stealthing just to get back to Fallon. And Loco not
nice
be able to make it back. Nice try. But that is a huge kill. Possibly the ace, though. Big Fat comes back just in time, but it is a little bit too late. I think we are going to get that game three.
Game three, come on.
There
yeah, Curse of You. They're taking this down. Fantastic play.
Wonderful job.
Really took an early control of the game. That was CLG's big chance to come back, but the great play from Patoy and Creighton. Patoy throwing himself at the enemy team just to make sure they wasted time, and Creighton with the perfect volley. A little bit of luck in his side in the end. Yeah, I'm not going to say that did not happen, but still looking so strong.
And, you know, that was the perfect opportunity for CLG to actually come on back from that. But it is just a little bit, just it is could not do it.
It did not work out in the air. They might have tried to save a cooldown. They might have not had it available. It just did not work. And sometimes that happens. Sometimes you expect your auto attack to crit. Maybe an unlucky crit does stop you. There was a little bit of luck there.
There was a little bit.
Definitely, but you know what?
But we're in the right place for it.
Yeah, we're in the right place for it. We're in Vegas. We're at IPL5. And in the end, CLG, they could not take as much advantage as they thought.
Yeah,
but it was not a sure thing.
But we will be getting a great game three.
That's
for
sure.
Both of these teams.
The first best of three of the day, I believe.
I think so. And so let's go real quick before we go to commercial break. How did the Twitch overall do?
Well, they could never get those team fights where he got everybody. Yeah. He got one or two people sometimes, and it was a lot of damage. They died. He did take people out, even in that last team fight. I think he got a kill just from spray and pray, but still, in the end, because he was not hitting everybody, they needed more damage. They were just a bit too far behind. No one on the team besides maybe Big Fat dealt that much damage, and that was a big problem. They just did not have the DPS, and Twitch did not have the gold.
Do you think we may be seeing the Twitch again, or where else do you think we may see
it? It did not do badly.
Yeah.
But you know what? Caitlyn did so well game one.
Yeah.
I mean, if they can get Vayne on double, if that is being banned out, but, you know, maybe go with something more traditional. That Twitch pick, it's always fun to see. It's always a bit of a gamble, but sometimes, and actually very often, has it won a game this tournament?
That, you know, I think you may be right.
Yeah, I don't think it, if you're right. Playing versus me, Playground, I believe, right?
Yeah, and then the Dynamic has been...
Yeah, Dynamic tried, did not work.
Yeah.
I do not believe Fear, or not Fear, I do not believe Twitch has won a game this tournament. Fear did win a game.
Yeah.
But they are sadly eliminated, but Twitch just not working out for anybody right now.
Lulu working out for everybody, though.
Lulu
we may
being
see,
awesome
we
as hell.
We may see her come back again for game number three. And
definitely.
A lot of Cho'Gath and Malphite did pretty well for, you know, they've been doing
Given
pretty well.
Given the circumstances, Cho'Gath and Malphite did okay.
Yeah.
I mean, in the end, Hotshot GG just didn't do enough. He just did not have that presence he had game one.
We'll see what happens going into game number three. Before we go to break, we want to thank all of our wonderful sponsors for making this happen. We want to thank you guys for tuning in all weekend long. Thank you for joining us, whether you're watching for free HD over at IGN.com or on Xbox Live 2. If you're not already, HD looks pretty nice.
As long as you got the passion, as long as you're watching the game, that's
all
we care about. Well,
that's all good.
Some people might care about some of this stuff, but I that's all I care about. Just enjoy and love the game. We'll be back soon.
Be back for game number three in just a little bit.